Retail workers of Reddit, what is the most desperate scam a customer has tried to pull on you? I was working at a place that has soft serve as a part of the menu. I was working one day and a lady came up to the counter and said something along the lines of, "Hey, I'm really sorry, my daughter dropped her ice cream and she's really sad about it. Do you think you could give me another?" I was about to then realize an important fact. The ice cream was broken that day and we weren't selling any. I looked back at her and told her that it must not be from us because of the machine. She turned bright red and mumbled, "Oh, then I guess it must be from Dairy Queen or something," and left quickly. Nice try, lady. We were at a soft serve place, not a chain, and my son actually did drop his ice cream right after he got it. I was fully prepared to purchase a new one, but they gave us another for free. That's the kind of behavior these scammers take advantage of, and it is a real payoff. This is why we can't all be nice to each other. I worked at a jewel many years ago. Opening shift as a cashier, a man comes through with two 24 packs of Pepsi. It's opening shift, so at that time we count our registers and confirm they've got the correct opening cash. We didn't carry too much cash, and we all know how much is in the drawer to start. He ends up paying with a $100 bill for these sodas. I counted back his change with mostly 20s. All the 20s I had just counted. There was no more 20s I could have given him. And I don't know how he did this, but he shuffled them in his hand and showed me that I supposedly shortchanged him. Now, I knew immediately that he was a piece of crap. My store wasn't crappy, so I told him that I would call a manager over and have them double check the register. The manager came, counted down the register and explained that the drawer was balanced, which means I didn't shortchange anybody. But if for whatever reason the drawer turned up $20 over at night, we could give him a call. The manager tries to take his info down and he asks for his name, and the guy thinks about it and says, "Steve Bush." "Frick you, Steve Bush. You're a sack of lying crap who tries to scam 16-year-olds out of $20. I'm well aware that money isn't my money, but I took that as a personal offense. When I left that day, I called my now husband, mad as heck. I felt angry because he must have assumed I looked like an idiot that would hand him extra money, or something of that nature. Also, he can't actually scam Jewel without scamming me first. Just because it isn't my money didn't mean he didn't try to scam me out of $20. We are responsible for how much money we lose. I didn't realize how common this was. People are crap. Huh. This is an extremely common scam. I would be shocked if any retail worker didn't have it happen to them at least once. 1. This projector is going to be used at our church. Can we get a discount? 2. This flat screen TV is going to be used at our church. Can you waive the taxes? 3. This for church. Discount? Worked at Arby's as a teenager. This was around 1990. A guy comes in, orders a sandwich and fries, and wants to pay with a check. This being the olden days, people paid with check all the time. But this guy tries to tell me it's easier for the bank if he makes it out to himself instead of to Arby's because, well, he fired off some convoluted, off-the-cuff bulls designed to gish gallop me into buying the story. I was young and naive, but not that naive. He got mad when I denied him, called me stupid. I asked if he'd like to talk to the manager and he agreed. 3 minutes later, my manager is giving the guy stink eye and the dude leaves with no sandwich. Nice try, butthole. I work at a movie theater. We have a $5 discount day. A customer comes over and starts telling me how she was there the prior day and that we had given them the wrong soda and her diabetic husband had drank it and suddenly had to go to the hospital to get medication to cure him. Several things wrong with that story. 1. That's not how diabetes works. You don't die from one sip of soda, and generally if you did, you'd have insulin to take. 2. The employee she had complained to in order to call me over had been the only concessionist the prior day and somehow she failed to identify him when I asked her who it was. I asked her for a ticket stubs or proof of purchase, and she came up with nothing. I went to the attendance for the prior day and pulled the report for the movie they claimed to have saw. To my delight, the showtime they claimed to have seen had zero tickets sold to it. I printed the report and went back to meet them. Yay. Sorry, looks like there were zero tickets sold to that showtime. And I showed her the report. She then tried to say we sold her tickets to the wrong movie. I told her that was impossible because then she would have been in the wrong auditorium. She had no response to that. Then she spluttered that she guessed she would just go buy tickets and I said yay, I guess so. She left. Telling me she had a voucher for 50% off in her emails, but she didn't have a copy with her. I was like, no hun, nice try. When I worked on a checkout, a woman pulled a barcode label from a container of $4 tinned fruit and stuck it over the barcode of a $25 container of medjooled dates. She pretended that she didn't do it. Another time a man carried a $30 bag of dog food the customer service counter without paying for it and asked for a refund. My manager gave it to him even though we both knew he had stole it while we watched him. Oh, and another time a group of people were using fake credit cards to steal. Not sure exactly how it worked, but they ended up typing in a different card number into the VFPurse terminal while another dude tried to distract you. These guys were super friendly and chatty and probably thought I was young and dumb, but I caught them trying to take off with about $500 worth of groceries. They were all like, just let us go and get some cash out. We'll be back soon to pay. They never returned and my manager gave me a box of chocolates for picking up on it. Proudest moment of my retail career. Former worker, name dropping the owner's name while saying everything was wrong and they were going to call him personally and were doing this super doucher buggy exaggerated phone button push thing. Surprise, surprise, they didn't know him. Passed it off as, well, he isn't answering with that voice that comes from a nose a mile high. I work at an Italian deli specialty market. It's family owned and has a super tight knit cast of employees. It's also in a rougher part of town. One day, a presumably homeless woman came into the store. No big deal, we're by the shelter and a lot of the homeless folks are friendly and just getting something nice to eat. However, this lady was clearly out of her mind. Whether it was drugs or mental illness wasn't clear. Honestly, probably both. She was in the store for an hour just harassing employees and customers. Eventually, the owner, the Italian man after which the store is named, had to intervene. He firmly asked the lady to leave, but she had a surprising response. Oh, it's okay, I work here. Imagine the surprise on the owner's face. He certainly didn't remember hiring her. Dumbfounded, he told her that was impossible, since he's in charge of the hiring. To which she responded, oh, are you hiring? Honestly, I've got to respect a good gambit. Unfortunately for her, it didn't seem to pan out. I don't have any new co-workers yet. I had a customer try to pay with a check using an ID that was very obviously made of paper. When I wouldn't accept it, she tried to get her boyfriend to fight me. He laughed and awkwardly walked out of the store, leaving her there, crying now. From the embarrassment of failure, I guess. I understand that some states issue paper temporary licenses. Mine does too. This was clearly not that. Good on the dude for making the right judgment call. Worked at Aldi, which is a return policy where you get your money back and get to pick an item of equal or lesser value. One customer routinely returned a gallon of milk with just a quarter remaining, claiming it was rancid. He'd then get a new gallon and his money back. This went on almost daily for 2 weeks until the DM finally put his foot down. Aldi will do anything to please the customer. It's insane. I'm a customer service manager at my store, and have been for two years, so I'm not exactly wet behind the ears. Every once in a while, I get a call from someone claiming to be NCR, the company who repairs our registers. They always start the same. We've been getting an error message from your store that your money services registers are out of sync. Usually I just say nice try and hang up. However, one night the store was dead. I was ahead on my closing stuff. I got the call. I pretended to be dumb and played along, telling him I was doing what he said. Stupid stuff that doesn't actually do anything. Reset the PIN pad. Reboot the register. Type in a code that prints a slip. So after about 10 minutes, I finally break the news to him that I knew it was a scam. He goes off yelling, I told your butt we're updating the freaking registers, you tucking dumbass. Not traditional retail, but had a client where she did not receive two packages from me and was refusing to pay the invoice for the second package from more than 6 months prior. I knew she was lying, but she was extremely rude and insistent. I was able to go back on all records and was able to find both a photo of the first package on her front doorstep. Super lucky, as it's not our normal delivery procedure to have photographed evidence. And a signature of receipt for the second one with her name very clearly signed. dated 4 days later. I emailed the evidence and never heard back from her again. Not even an apology email or phone call, which just confirms she knew she was lying. Lately I always get a photo of the Amazon package where the mailman left it. It's actually quite interesting. They cut off a tag off an expensive jacket. I saw them do this. Walked up to me and tried to return it. Security showed them the doors. This probably doesn't really count as a scam, but had a teenage boy come into the store and say he had no money but needed condoms desperately for tonight or he wouldn't lose his virginity. I really felt for the dude, so I ended up buying him some myself. I work at a clothing store, and about a year ago I had a very drunk 50 plus year old lady come through my line. After ringing up her $100 plus worth of clothes, she then began to hit on me and insinuate that she could work for the free clothes, if you get what I mean. That was the quickest nope I have ever said in my life. Would not recommend, lol. Lure her to the bathroom, tell her to wait and come back with mop, buckets and gloves. Used to work customer service at a hardware store. You get so jaded by junkies trying to return stolen items. I just started handing out refunds based on how good the stories were. Your dad with dementia bought circuit breakers every single day and recently died? Refund. You don't need these commercial sized copper elbows because you bought too many for your residential plumbing project? Nah. The dementia thing is sadly realistic. My uncle recently died of Lewy body dementia. And he kept on buying tools and fishing gear. It made him happy. My auntie would collect them once they got home and put them away to return later. But you couldn't stop him because he would get so angry if he was told he couldn't. Had a guy try to return two Sega CD games for cash. Problem was they were wrapped in saran wrap. And then had the gall to exchange them for properly wrapped games so he could go across the street to Walmart and return them for cash there. Him and his buddy must have really needed beer and weed money. Also have seen people try on new shoes, put the old ones in the box, and walk out with the new ones. Had an old man act like he was pulling a gun out of his waist just to get away from loss prevention. And one of my favorites, had the two women grab a bag from luggage and put all of the rolls of film in the bag. Then try to ditch the bag because we were following them. I worked for my mom-in-law at a home decor store. I had an older woman come in and when I rang her up she said she got a discount because she was the owner's mom. My immediate reaction was to yell, "Grandma," and throw my arms out like I wanted a hug. She left very quickly. BTW, it was not my grandma-in-law. Lmao, I would have loved to have seen that. When I worked at the service desk of a local grocery store, we had this lady who was super skinny and wore sunglasses and long sleeves all the time. One day she came in with a friend and tried to return beauty items. We didn't have a beauty makeup section, and claimed she had no receipt due to short-term memory loss. It was so hard not to laugh in her face. She had attempted to return things this way numerous times. We all knew what she was doing. Maybe she couldn't remember that she had tried that before. Customer shows me a coupon on his phone. Several problems with this. It's against corporate policy to scan coupons off the phone. There's a sheet of paper taped to the counter with all of the rules and it's like the sixth one on it. When my kowtowing ass munch of a manager scanned the stupid freaking thing anyways, the system rejected the coupon saying that the coupon wasn't issued to him. The offer that the coupon was for was different than the offer shown on his phone. There was an Instagram stamp on the coupon on his phone. Also, customer tries to return some makeup without a receipt. I look it over and tell her I can't return it. She tries to say that we have to since we sell it here and whatnot. I tell her I can't return it because it has a security label from the grocery store that's 5 miles down the road. She books it out and leaves said makeup behind. I had someone try to return 2 bottles of laundry detergent. She dropped them off at the counter and said she didn't like that brand. She walks off to do her shopping. I wonder how it smells, so I open the detergent and smell it. It's water. Both of these jugs are filled with warm water. During the exchange she tries to claim they were like that when she bought them. I explain I can't return them and she will have to talk to the day manager. Boss lady who has final say. A friend of mine bought a giant bottle of laundry detergent that turned out to be water. He was so perplexed when he got it home and tried to wash his clothes. Someone must have bought it, filled it with water and returned it, and obviously it wasn't checked. Luckily he was able to exchange it at the store with no questions asked but a lot of laughs all around. I work at a convenience store, and we sell phone chargers for exorbitant prices because they prey on the desperate who need a charger right now. People steal these chargers all the time and try to bring them back for a refund. We don't take them back without a receipt with our store address on it anymore because this is such a common occurrence. I also had a guy steal a fidget spinner. I watched him do it from the aisle and try to bring it back for the whole refund of $6. Customer came in for her 1-hour facial appointment to try our skincare brand in a department store. It was $75, or you could purchase products to that value or above. She came out from her facial, pampered, requested the whole range, then exclaimed she had left her credit card in her bag which she had left in the car. She quickly said, "I'll be back in 5, and never returned. We cottoned on pretty quickly, but she had disappeared, and the phone number she had given us was fake. I worked at a place that sold timber, roofing, iron, etc. One sat morning this guy comes in and wants a couple of bags of cement, so I ring up the sale, and then go to load up the order. He tells me not to worry, and that he will do it, so I explain that it is my job to do it. Then when I reached for the first one he stands between me and the bag. So again I insist that I have to load the concrete, it isn't an option. At this point he gets quite aggressive with yelling and arm waving etc. So I go inside to find the boss, and just as we come back out he reaches down, goes to pick up the bag, and throws his back out. He is writhing around on the floor for a while, then demands an ambulance, and tells my boss that I refuse to help him load the bags and now he is going to sue us for millions. What he didn't know is that a lot of people tried to steal the cement, so there were 2 security cameras pointing right at him the whole time, recording everything he said and did, including a long discussion with his wife about how we would pay him a stack of cash to keep this out of court and so on. The company didn't say a word about the tapes until just before we had to be in court, to make sure that he spent as much money on his lawyer as possible. I once had a dude try to score a free iPhone. He came into the department I worked in, and started describing this vague iPhone to us, saying he'd lost it in here earlier. No other details were given, like phone case, or specific color, just an iPhone. Further questions were asked about where he thinks he might have left it in here and he just went quiet and said, "It's fine. Actually, maybe somebody else has it, and left." Our opinion is he knew that sometimes stores will keep people's phones that they find until the owners come back and then they hand over the phone. He wanted to score a free iPhone. My son actually lost his phone in an arcade restaurant type place, and the cashier had it in her drawer in lost and found. She wouldn't give us the phone until he told her what was on the lock screen to verify it was his. I thought that was a pretty good thing to do. Had a guy come to the bowling alley I worked at wanting to play in our arcade. You have to put money on a card to play the games cause we have card swipers on all our games and tickets go straight to the card. He walks into the redemption store I'm in and goes, "Hey man, I just put $20 in the teller and it took my money and is saying I didn't put anything in. Can you give me a card with $20 on it?" "Well, that's weird. Let's check it out." I grab a manager and walk over to the teller where the manager proceeds to open it up and take out the cash box and will you look there, not a single bill. Hum, weird. Do these other tellers work? Yeah bud, all the tellers work just fine. I worked at Best Buy in the late 90s when I was an HS and a guy set off the alarm when he was leaving and it turned out he had like 8 CDs in his pockets which he claimed that he had bought at the mall across the street before he came to Best Buy and it must have been his house arrest anklet that had set off the alarm. Had a young guy trying to buy alcohol once try to use his girlfriend's ultrasound as it. Tried to tell him that you don't have to be over 18 to get pregnant. In the end I just pointed at the poster that showed the approved forms of it we could accept and told him that ultrasounds weren't on it. So many people seem to forget their license at home. Well, go get it, buddy. You won't get a beer until I see it. Customer returned a fake ring for $100. They had a real receipt that physically described the ring they brought in. I didn't recognize it, even checked for it, but ultimately accepted the return because it seemed legit. What they did was buy a real ring, or obtain a real receipt some other way, then buy a fake $5 ring that matched the description on the real receipt. Return fake ring, get cash. Actually pretty smart. I was working at Buckle for a while in college. They offer 10% military discount with PhotoID. Lady comes to my register on Black Friday with an alleged photocopy of her husband's DD-214. I kindly told her that would not be accepted and she was not eligible for a discount unless she could produce dependent ID on an official card. She was P. I gave zero fricks. Guess who paid full price? If her husband is in the military, they issue spousal cards in order to access things like the base operated shops. I had one as a dependent and my mother still has hers though my father is retired. If she was really married to a military member, she would have her own card. I've been in and out of retail for 10 years, and one time at a part-time gig that I had. I have a full-time job, too. This couple, a man and a woman, came in, looking sketchy as all heck. Definitely had a drug problem. They were scanning each and every register looking for gift cards, particularly those ones where they were prepaid like Visa or MasterCard. I knew their game. I've dealt with this before. The woman came to my register. Originally they wanted to go to self-checkout, but I told them they cannot purchase gift cards there. They can. I just wanted to catch them lol. The woman comes up to me, purchases $400 worth of gift cards, and when it's time to pay, I ask her for her ID because she wants to use her credit card. The ID she had and who she was were two different people. The woman in the driver's license had no tattoos on her face. This woman had stars below her eye. I told her, this is not you. I will not sell these to you, and I will call the police. She booked it out of there. Unfortunately, the man got away with it, because he had purchased his at another register before the woman came to me. And would you believe, I got in trouble for doing that? Customer asked us to open the packaging for something in front of a manager and a co-worker, is happy with the product and takes that, goes to the cashiers and ask for a discount because the packaging was open. Though cashiers called a manager for their permission and it was the same manager who helped open the product. Not exactly a scam, but two-ish years ago I had a customer try to use a coupon from 2011. His excuse was that he'd been on the road a lot and didn't get a chance to use it. Tried to argue with me and demanded the manager who, no surprise, said there was nothing we could do and he finally backed down. I was in line behind a lady at HomeGoods, and from what I heard she had taken clearance stickers off items and then stuck them on full price items. She had done this with all 10 plus things in her cart. The cashier called her out so hard. For a couple things she was like, I just put these on the floor myself yesterday, and the lady got all huffy and stormed out. It was pretty funny. A customer called my company and complained that my shirt was untucked just to get free coupons. This woman made such a mess out of nothing, and I almost got a write-up over it. I had a customer call in and complain about me because I explained to her that our coffee shop did not have a short size and the smallest cups we had were called small size. Of course, corporate gave her a $5 gift card or something like that. Rewarding bad behavior, IMO. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.